I'd like to bring the Monday, May 2nd, 2016 board meeting to order. Please stand for the pledge of allegiance. Roll call, Mrs. Ward.
Mr. Casey.
Present.
Mr. Dwyer.
Present.
Mr. Duffy. Mr. Lesh.
Here.
Mr. McAndrew.
Present.
Mrs. Oleski.
Here.
Mr. Schuster.
Present.
Mr. Tinlin.
Present.
Mr. Sheridan.
Present.
Eight present, one absent.
Student recognition and public relations.
Members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, it is the recommendation of the Education Committee that the following resolution be approved. Whereas a quality education is the cornerstone of democratic society, and whereas teachers impact millions of lives in their roles as educators, motivators, and mentors, and whereas teachers work tirelessly to serve their students in the classroom and community with compassion and professionalism, and whereas the National Parent Teachers Association observation of Teacher Appreciation Week occurs annually each May, and now therefore be it resolved that the Board of Education supports the National Teacher Appreciation Week initiative from May 1st through May 7th, and does hereby encourage the community to recognize the important role teachers play in society. Respectfully submitted.
Second.
Hearing a second on the question. I hear any question. Roll call.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Oleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Tinlin?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Eight affirmative.
Now, each of our schools will receive a copy of the resolution from the board announcing and celebrating Teacher Appreciation Week. Members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, it is the recommendation of the Education Committee that the following resolution be approved. Whereas the Board of School Directors is always eager to recognize students who have distinguished themselves academically and in an extracurricular activity, and whereas Brian Martin, an outstanding senior student at West Granton High School, has been selected as West Granton High School's 2016 Northeast Educational Intermediate Unit 19 Scholar of the Year, and whereas Brian Martin, an outstanding senior at West Granton High School, has been selected to the 2016 Scranton Times Tribune Scholastic Superstar Team, and whereas Brian Martin is an active member in several clubs at West Granton High School, including the O'Brien Youth Leadership Program, Leadership Lackawanna, National Honor Society, Student Council President, Sophomore Class President, Captain of the Cross Country Team, Captain of the Swimming and Diving Team, Captain of the Track and Field Team, Scholastic Bowl Competitor, Build an Invader Mentor, Red Cross Club, Spirit Club, and Ski Club, and whereas Brian Martin is in the West Granton High School Class of 2016, the valedictorian, and has been accepted to attend the University of Scranton, where he has earned a full presidential scholarship and will major in biology and chemistry with the intent of having a career in the medical field. And now, therefore, be it resolved that the official congratulations of the Board of Education is extended to Brian Martin, his parents, Paul and Kathy Martin, and his teachers at West Granton High School, respectively submitted.
Second.
Hearing a second. Second, other questions?
Yes, I have a question. I'd just like to personally congratulate that young man and his parents and our outstanding teachers here at West Granton and throughout the district. That's quite a feat and quite an accomplishment. And congratulations. Any question, Brian? What do you do with all your spare time?
Congratulations to Mom and Dad. And to grandparents also, who are West Granton people from forever, Mr. Martinelli, Mrs. Martinelli especially.
Congratulations on behalf of the whole board, too. Good job. The parents in. Yes. Roll call.
Mr. Dwight?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olefsky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Tinlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Eight affirmative.
To the members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, it is the recommendation of the Education Committee that the following resolution be approved. Whereas the Board of School Directors is always eager to recognize students who have distinguished themselves academically and in extracurricular activities, and whereas Daniel Sellerday, an outstanding senior at West Scranton High School, has been selected to the 2016 Scranton Times Tribune Scholastic Superstar Team, and whereas Daniel Sellerday is an active member in several clubs at West Scranton High School, including a captain of the boys soccer team, track and field team, president of the National Honor Society, president of the Pride team, president of the ski club, build and invader mentor, peer mediation team, scholastic world team, FBLA, leadership Lackawanna, and Latin club. And whereas Daniel Sellerday has been accepted to attend college where he will major in astrophysics, and now therefore be it resolved that the official congratulations of the Board of Education is extended to Daniel Sellerday, his parents Edwin and Terry Sellerday, and his teachers at West Scranton High School, respectfully submitted.
Second. Here in a second, other question?
I'd just like to say again, Mr. President, I'd like to thank this young man and his family and teachers, you know, astrophysics, biology, math. I mean, these are great things. This is certainly what this country needs today, as you know, we are a growing country. We continue to grow, and these outstanding academics, I just can't say enough. Congratulations.
On behalf of the board and the superintendent, we extend our congratulations both to the parents and the student. Good job. Roll call.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olefsky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Tinlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, it is the recommendation of the Education Committee that the following resolution be approved. Whereas the Board of School Directors is always eager to recognize students who have distinguished themselves academically and in extracurricular activities, and whereas Jake McDonald, an outstanding senior at West Scranton High School, has been selected to the 2016 Scranton Times Tribune Scholastic Superstar Team, and whereas Jake McDonald is an active member in several clubs at West Scranton High School, including the National Honor Society, Vice President of the Student Council, Vice President of the Spirit Club, Freshman Class President, Scholastic Bowl Team, Captain of the Boys Soccer Team, Baseball Team, Build an Invader Mentor, Red Cross Club, FBLA, 2013 and 2015 Silver Medalist on the National Spanish Exam, 2014 Gold Medalist on the National Spanish Exam, and Peer Mediation. And whereas Jake McDonald has been accepted and will attend the University of Scranton, where he will major in neuroscience, and now therefore be it resolved that the official congratulations of the Board of Education is extended to Jake McDonald, his parents, Thomas and Kristen McDonald, and his teachers at West Scranton High School, respectively submitted.
Second. Here in a second, another question.
Just like to repeat myself again. Thank you, Jake, and your family and these teachers. Neuroscience, I mean, these are just three outstanding fields that we've just heard about that these young men are going to go into. I can't believe it. I just wish you guys the best of luck, and you know what? Bring that knowledge back here.
And Jake, on behalf of the school board and the superintendent, we extend your congratulations to both you and your parents. Great job. Roll call.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olefsky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Tinlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
From the members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, it is the recommendation of the Education Committee that the following resolution be approved. Whereas the Board of School Directors is always eager to recognize students who have distinguished themselves academically and in extracurricular activities, and whereas Madeline Condon, an outstanding senior at Scranton High School, has been selected to the 2016 Scranton Times Tribune Scholastic Superstar Team, And whereas, Madeline Condon is an active member in several clubs and activities at Scranton High School, including the Scholastic Bowl Team, Future Business Leaders of America, Speech and Debate, SAD, Link Crew, Peer Tutoring, Community Connections to Our Watershed, a member of the National Honor Society, Senior Class Treasurer, and a four-year member of the Varsity Cross Country Team. And whereas, Madeline Condon has been accepted and will attend Colgate University and major in mathematics. And now, therefore, be it resolved that the official congratulations of the Board of Education is extended to Madeline Condon, her parents Gerard and Michelle Condon, and her teachers at Scranton High School, respectively submitted.
Second. Hearing a second, under the question.
Yes, again, Mr. President, I would just like to congratulate Madeline. I would just like to say this again is another major in mathematics. Colgate University. This is the kind of education that these children are receiving in the Scranton School District. This is the cooperation between children, parents, and teachers. I just can't say any more about it. Congratulations.
Again, on behalf of the school district, or the school board, and the superintendent, extended to Madeline and her parents, congratulations, good job. Roll call.
Mrs. Zaleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, it is the recommendation of the Education Committee that the following resolution be approved. Whereas the Board of School Directors is always eager to recognize students who have distinguished themselves academically and in extracurricular activities, and whereas Sajak Delawar, an outstanding senior at Scranton High School, competed in and won the first place individual award at the Kane Physics Competition that was held at the University of Scranton on April 20th, 2016. And whereas Sajad competed against the over 210 physics students from 14 area high schools to win the individual physics award and placed first in a written exam and in a Jeopardy-style contest event that tested physics knowledge in the areas of mechanics, waves, optics, electromagnetism, and circuits. And whereas Sajad Delawar is an active member in several clubs at Scranton High School, including the mock trial team, tech club, peer tutoring, student council, and he's a member of the National Honor Society. And whereas Sajad Delawar has been accepted into and will attend Penn State University, where he will be majoring in aerospace engineering. Now, therefore be it resolved that the official congratulations of the Board of Education is extended to Sajad Delawar, his mother Flora Tallim, his physics teacher, Mrs. Lorraine Babarski, and all of his teachers at Scranton High School, respectively submitted.
Second. Hearing a second, under the question.
Just like again, Mr. President, congratulate Sajad and his family and these teachers again. I mean, here we are, aerospace engineering, it can't get any better. Congratulations, Sajad.
On behalf of the school board and the superintendent, Sajad, congratulations, and to his parents, great job. Roll call.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Zaleski?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Data Furman.
Members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, it is the recommendation of the Education Committee that the following resolution be approved. Whereas, the Board of School Directors is always eager to recognize students who have distinguished themselves academically and in extracurricular activities. And whereas the following eighth grade students at West Scranton Intermediate School, Austin Bentler, Randy Bonitz, Brian Bresser, Fiona Evans, Paige Fuller, Nick Guerrera, Antonio Pugliese, Emily Tunis, Emily Van Wert, and Garrett Walsh competed in the Regional Pennsylvania Junior Academy of Science competition on Saturday, March 5th, 2016 at Wilkes University with 793 other students from surrounding school districts in our region. The PJAS is a statewide organization of students, grades 7 through 12, designed to stimulate and promote interest in science among its members through the development of research projects and investigations. Whereas, to compete in this competition, each student selects a unique research topic be investigated through both written resources and experimentation. This done by collecting real-time data and analyzing results to make meaningful conclusions. Their methods and results are then accumulated in a presentation to present to a panel of judges, all of which is done on the student's own time with guidance from both their parents and their sponsor, Mr. Frank Wall, science teacher at West Grand High School. Whereas Austin Bentler, Randy Bonitz, Ryan Bresser, Fiona Evans, Paige Fuller, Nick Guerrera, Emily Tunis, and Emily Van Wert earned second awards in their categories at the regional competition, Garrett Walsh and Antonio Pugliese earned first awards in their categories and will move on to compete at the state-level competition at Penn State University main campus in May. Whereas West Grand Intermediate School and the Education Committee would also like to recognize the efforts of Mr. Frank Wall, West Grand High School biology teacher, who dedicated countless hours, resources, and support to these students as their PJAS sponsor. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the official congratulations of the Board of Education is extended to Austin, Randy, Ryan, Fiona, Paige, Nick, and the two Emilys, and Garrett Walsh and Antonio, their parents and their sponsor, Mr. Frank Wall, from West Grand High School, respectively submitted.
Second. Here to second on the question.
Yes, on the question. I would just like again to congratulate all these students, and a special congratulations to Mr. Frank Wall. You guys keep going, keep doing that good work. Make us proud.
And again, from the Scranton School Board and the Superintendent, we extend our congratulations to all the students, their parents, their teachers. Great job. Roll call.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Eight affirmative.
Members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, it is the recommendation of the Education Committee that the following resolution be approved. Whereas the Board of School Directors is always eager to recognize students who have distinguished themselves academically and in extracurricular activities, and whereas these three West Grand Intermediate School students, Cabre Capilongo, Olivia Trapper, and Olivia Minnick, are seventh grade students who recently competed in the Lackawanna County Women's History Bookmark Contest, and whereas over the course of the project research historically significant women in Lackawanna County, focusing on those who have made major contributions to the community. Furthermore, these students have concentrated their energies on women who have made a substantial mark on our community, but have not been widely publicized. Culmination of this effort resulted in a bookmark design featuring their research subjects, and whereas Cabre Capilongo, Olivia Trapper, and Olivia Minnick distinguished themselves by placing first, second, and third, respectively, in the Lackawanna County Women's History Month Bookmark Contest, bookmarks created by the students were reproduced and will be distributed throughout the community. And now, therefore, be it resolved that the official congratulations of the Board of Education is extended to Cabre Capilongo, Olivia Trapper, Olivia Minnick, their parents, their project coordination teacher, Mrs. Michelle Borthwick, and all their teachers and administrators at West Grand Intermediate School, respectfully submitted.
Second. Here in a second, under the question.
On the question, I'd just like to again congratulate and recognize these individuals on all this great, you know, bookwork or bookmark contest. I'll tell you, it's just so great to recognize all of our children tonight. This is a great, great event. You've really, I'm telling you, it's amazing. Thank you.
Again, on behalf of the school board and the superintendent, congratulations extended to the parents, the students, and all of the teachers. Great job. Roll call.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Eight affirmative.
I just take a moment, Mr. Chairman. The three women that were saluted in the bookmark contest. Actually, it's two of the contest winners chose the same person, Mary Brooks Pickin by Cabre Capilongo and Olivia Minnick, and the late Mary Scranton was selected by Olivia Trapp.
Nice job.
Members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, It is recommendation of the Education Committee that the following resolution be approved. Whereas the Board of School Directors is always eager to recognize students who have distinguished themselves academically and in extracurricular activities, and these two West Grant Intermediate School students, Molly Doherty, 7th grade, and Samantha Mushak, 8th grade, recently competed in the 2016 National PTA Reflections Contest to recognize achievements in the arts. And whereas, over the course of the contest, Molly and Samantha individually choreographed, rehearsed, performed, and recorded original dance productions to illustrate the contest theme, Let Your Imagination Fly. The culmination of this effort resulted in recognition and placement at the local, regional, and state levels, and whereas Molly Doherty and Samantha Mushak distinguished themselves by placing first and third, respectively, at the state level in the 2016 National PTA Reflections Contest, with Molly Doherty's first place submission advancing to the national level for judging, and now therefore be it resolved that the official congratulations of the Board of Education is extended to Molly Doherty and Samantha Mushak, their parents, teachers, and administrators at the West Grant Intermediate School, respectfully submitted. Second.
Here in a second, on the question.
Yes, on the question, Mr. President. I would just like to congratulate Molly and Samantha for their hard work, and just say it's great to have these children bring Scranton to the forefront on the state level and now on the national level. You just can't say any more about these kids tonight. Congratulations.
And on behalf of the school board and superintendent, extend to Molly, Samantha, and their parents and their teachers, great job. Roll call.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olesky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. DeWiecki?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, it is the recommendation of the Education Committee that the following resolution be approved. Whereas the Board of School Directors is always eager to recognize students who have distinguished themselves academically and in extracurricular activities, and whereas these two West Grant Intermediate School students, Fiona Evans and Abby O'Brien, are extremely bright, hardworking, and dedicated 8th grade students who recently competed in the 2016 National C-SPAN Student Cam Video Competition, and whereas over the course of 5 months, these creative and civic-minded students thoroughly research immigration issues from the local, state, and national perspectives, developed interview questions, interviewed policymakers, chose and shot on-location video footage, and edited audio and video components of the project aimed at convincing presidential candidates to discuss and resolve immigration issues. And whereas Fiona and Abby distinguished themselves by being awarded a second place prize in the 2016 National C-SPAN Student Cam Video Documentary Competition for their National Immigration Issues Video Project. And now, therefore, be it resolved that the official congratulations of the Board of Education is extended to Fiona Evans and Abby O'Brien, their parents, their project coordination teacher, Mrs. Erin Mangan, and all their teachers and administrators at West Grant Intermediate School, respectively submitted.
Second. Here in a second, under the question.
Yes, again, Mr. President, I'd like to graduate Fiona and Abby, again, two children bringing, again, Scranton to the forefront with the C-SPAN Student Cam Video Document. Congratulations. And what an issue. National immigration issues. That is a national issue. That's a main focus of this presidential election. Thank you.
Sheridan, may I add something on the question?
Sure.
I believe, in addition to the outstanding work of Fiona and Abby, Mrs. Mangan and I believe Mr. Mahern have done this before. We've had a C-SPAN award presented to the students at West Grant 2 years ago in their video presentation. So this is consistent performance from our faculty as well as our students. And again, I'd like to applaud all of them again.
On behalf of the school board and the superintendent, to Fiona, Abby, their parents, the teachers, congratulations, great job done. Roll call.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Oleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
To the members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, it is the recommendation of the Superintendent and the Education Committee that the following resolution be approved. Whereas the Board of School Directors of the Scranton School District is always eager to recognize vital community partners that make a difference in the lives of our students, and whereas the Lackawanna Historical Society and Albright Memorial Library have formed an alliance to foster the knowledge and appreciation of the history and culture of Lackawanna County by providing educational programs and student accessibility of library materials and the artifact archive collection. And whereas the Lackawanna Historical Society and the Albright Memorial Library share the goals of the Scranton School District to educate young people about our local history, foster pride in our community, and increase civic efficacy. And whereas the Lackawanna Historical Society was successfully given a community needs grant from the Scranton Area Foundation in the amount of $12,000 for the purpose of creating a local history curriculum. And whereas these funds are to be partially used to subsidize Scranton School District teachers involved in designing this curriculum, now therefore be it resolved that the Board of Directors of the Scranton School District will fully cooperate with these community partners by supporting local history in the social studies curriculum and by providing three district teachers to collaborate with the Lackawanna Historical Society and Albright Memorial Library in shaping the design of the local history curriculum. Respectfully submitted.
Second.
Here in a second. Under question? No question? I'd just like to say under question that I'd like to take at this time thanking the Lackawanna Historical Society and the Albright Memorial Library for what they do for us and our children. They're there for all the time for us. The library is great. Over the years, it's really given up, and they've done a lot with the library and the Historical Society. Again, congratulations on behalf of the whole board. Roll call.
Mrs. Oleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Eight affirmative.
Okay, report from student representatives, West Scranton Intermediate School.
Hello, my name is Emily Tunis. We are students from West Scranton Intermediate School, and we are thrilled to be here. We are here to discuss the things we have completed over the 2015 to 2016 school year. We will talk about three specific areas: arts, academics, and achievements.
Hello, my name is Nicholas Guerra. These are our accomplishments in the arts. Two WSIS students won at the state level for the category of dance in the PTA Reflections Contest. Molly Doherty, 7th grade, won first place. Samantha Mushak, 8th grade, won third place. Other students won at the local level for the category of literature in the PTA Reflections Contest. These students were Bibi Backus, Kaden Gallagher, Dominic Viscomi, and Taryn Loney. Our school put on spectacular plays this school year. They were Asylum of Death and Insane Wrestling Federation. The drama club, under the supervision of Ms. King and Mr. Yagavazi, all did a fantastic job with these plays. Mr. Yagavazi wrote and produced all of the music for each of the original productions.
We had many academic accomplishments here at West Intermediate. We have accomplished things such as 10 8th grade WSIS students participated in the Pennsylvania Junior Academy of Science contest. We spent the day at Wilkes University presenting our science experiments that we completed over the course of 4 months. We had a great experience exploring the campus, and we placed very high. The following students placed second: Austin Bentler, Brandy Bonnet, Brian Bresser, Fiona Evans, Paige Fuller, Nick Guerra, Emily Tunis, and Emily Bimmer. And the following students placed first: Garrett Walsh and Antonio Pugliese. Students also participated in the Patriots Pen Essay Contest. The theme this year is What Freedom Means to Me. Fareed Kadus, an 8th grade student, won 4th place in the contest. We have started using new programs at our school called Google Drive, Google Docs, and Google Classroom. Our teachers can give us assignments through any connected device. Students then have the ability to communicate and collaborate with their classmates and teachers. All Google products are accessible at home and school. Our Pride Homeroom is a group of 8th grade students who represent WSAS in a positive way. We tutor our peers, run the school store, and help plan invader days. We've also helped construct several projects for our school. Hi, my name is Yasmin Ramirez, and here at Western New Media, we have achieved many things throughout the 2015 to 2016 school year. These achievements consist of two students, Fiona Evans and Abby O'Brien, excelled in the C-SPAN National Student Camp Contest. Their project about immigration issues placed second out of the thousands of entries submitted from around the United States. After receiving the $1,500 reward, they are going to donate it to the Bhutanese community of Scranton. The award ceremony will be on May 4th, that's this Wednesday, at 10 a.m. at WSIS, and you are all invited to attend. In the Lackawanna County Women's History Bookmark Contest, Western Two Media swept the top three prizes. Kiwi Capilongo, Olivia Trapper, and Olivia Minnick, all 7th grade students, took first, second, and third place in the competition.
In conclusion, here at West Scranton Intermediate School, we have triumphed in the areas of the arts, academics, and achievements throughout the 2015 to 2016 school year. We're proud of the hard work of all of our students, teachers, and administrators. Thank you, and West is best.
Report from the PSBA representatives, Director Dwight.
Nothing at this time, Director Sheridan.
Thank you. Solicitor's report, Attorney Gavinor.
Yes, executive sessions were held on Monday, April 4th, April 25th, and this evening, May 2nd, 2016, to discuss litigation, real estate, personnel, and labor relations. Thank you.
Thank you. Superintendent's report, Dr. Alexis Kieran.
This week is Teacher Appreciation Week, and from the administration and myself, we would like to thank our teachers for all they do every day for our students. We've planned some special events for throughout the week for our teachers and hope that you enjoy. Students from throughout our district took part in the celebration of events commemorating the 25th anniversary of the USS Scranton. This was a unique history lesson, and several of our students were fortunate enough to participate. On Thursday, April 28th, members of our Scranton High School's AP U.S. History class appeared on Newswatch 16 with Ryan Legge to kick off the event celebrating the USS Scranton. A big thank you to Mr. Jason Orlando and the students who arrived at the library at 4:30 a.m. for the taping. On Sunday, May 1st, members of West Scranton High School's chorus sang the national anthem at the celebration for 9 of the 11 commanders of the USS Scranton. They were accompanied by their teacher, Mrs. Karen Lutz. This morning, members of Northeast Intermediate School's 8th grade Honors History program attended a presentation by several of the former commanders and veterans who served on the submarine. They were accompanied by their teachers, Mr. John Hoover and Mr. Bobby Moraes. It was an honor to have our students take such an active part in this special celebration, which distinguishes again our city in history with the namesake of the USS Grant. Thank you, Mr. Sheridan.
Thank you, Doctor. Report from the PTA representative.
I don't think anyone's here.
One's here. Okay, public comment, Mr. Bert Genalesa.
Thank you, school board. And again, I thank you for the opportunity for allowing us to host another school board meeting like we did in March. I appreciate that very much. And on behalf of the West Grant community, I thank you for everything, for your unwavering support and dedication to our school. And to show a small token of our appreciation, our student council would like to give you a small gift.
Gentlemen, I'd just like to say that it's a pleasure of the whole board. Every time we come over to West Scranton, this is a great school. We love coming to my side and being your guest.
We appreciate it too, Mr. Sheridan. Thank you. And I also like to, at this point, acknowledge the teachers, their National Teacher Appreciation Week. They do a great job with our students. We appreciate all their efforts that they do day for their daily instruction for our students. Again, thank you for allowing us to host another school board meeting, and we look forward in the future to host more. Thank you.
Rosemary Boland, Scranton Federation of Teachers.
Directors, I'm so thrilled with your last few remarks. I'll be sure to remind all of you of those remarks next December when you and I sit down again to negotiate a new collective bargaining agreement. My members are thrilled to hear those kind remarks. I too, Dr. Kerrion, want to say how fortunate our students were today and yesterday to participate in the ceremonies around the USS Scranton. I had the privilege of being aboard that boat, and we were there for the commemorating of it, and went to the Campbell Shipyards down in Virginia. It was quite an occasion. I wanted to always thank former Mayor Dave Wenzel for getting that group of us together to go down to Virginia and participate. It was a very, very interesting occasion, one I won't soon forget. The first commander brought his crew here to Scranton. He felt it was imperative for them to understand this community for which their boat was named. And so former Congressman Joe McDade had a great hand in that. And it's an event I will never forget, and I hope the students who participated will never forget it either. And especially to pray constantly for the men and women who serve in our armed forces in this nation, protecting their rights, such as the right I have tonight to stand before you and address you in expressing my right to for freedom of speech. I notice in your packet there's something called Standards of Conduct Policy and other such papers for adoption this evening. This is the first we've seen them and haven't had very much time to read them. We haven't had much time to study them, and I would hope that in the future, such documents are going to be presented at a public meeting, there would be certainly enough time for discourse so that we could offer our opinions regarding such adoption. There's a few issues in there. For example, you were just presented gifts from the student body here. I'm wondering if you're allowed to take.
We are.
Next. Well, I don't know about that. Next.
We are.
Well, that's your opinion, sir.
That's it.
Public policy is that we get a chance
packet.
To even read. Next, Teacher Appreciation Week, we would like to call to your attention the fact that on Wednesday, May 4th, we're going to have what we're calling nationwide a walk-in. We want to demonstrate for all eyes that this is something that we must do to ensure our students have the schools they so richly deserve. Tonight, we have several students in this part of the city and over at Scranton High School. I'm sure if we had an opportunity, we wouldn't be able to provide you with a huge list of students and all of their current achievements. We're so very proud of our students and mostly very, very appreciative to the parents of all of our students who take time to help us with their children to give them the education they so richly deserve. We're very, very thankful to those parents for for their participation. We hope to see all of you Wednesday at a school. I challenged Mr. Marichak today. He's a student from Adams School. I hope to see Mr. Marichak and John Adams bright early Wednesday. And I know Dr. Kerrion told me she'll be going to a building. I certainly plan on being at a school, and I hope each of you pick one and participate in what we call the walk-in. It's nationwide, and we're talking hundreds of thousands of people participating across the United States of America. Next. Last week I was at a school board meeting, and this document, which was online, was passed by this board. It says, Scranton School District, Scranton Special Education Plan Report 7-1-2016, 6-30-2019, and the board passed that paper report, which will go to the PDE. I don't know how many of you had an opportunity to read all of the pages contained herein, but we've had enough time to study it, to question it. There are several interesting parts to this at the very beginning, the first 10 or 12, 15 pages at the very beginning. Since this document has now gone to the PDE, this document says that, A, we have a crisis management program in this district and everyone has been trained who needs to be trained in that. I would challenge that. I am challenging it. It also stipulates that we have enough resources for our special education system here. I challenge that and I question it. We don't. We absolutely do not. Our people, we are hiring people, for example, paraprofessionals, very dangerous work in some situations. Today in my office, a woman came in who was a paraprofessional in this district, and I wish you could have seen her face. Her face was marred Friday in school. She was attacked by a student. Another person had to come in and help. And that teacher, that paraprofessional, said to me today, you know, I can't go to work every day. I can't get hurt every day. We need support, and we need the right kind of support. Textbook support, paper and pencil support, soft manipulatives, that if a student in special needs throws those manipulatives, they don't hurt anybody. Soft classrooms, materials inside a classroom that are materials that facilitate the education of those special needs children. You have so many lawsuits. I hear about them constantly. I hear about settlements. If this document is picked up by any attorney who represents these kids, this is the document you'll be held accountable for. And I think somebody should have perused it. There are grammatical mistakes in here. The dates in here are incorrect. Spelling mistakes. I don't think this should have gone 30 days on the internet without us knowing about it. So those of us who like to read things like this and check them out for accuracy could have had an opportunity to do that and perhaps helped you, the board, in making the correct decision. This should have been edited before it went out to the PDE. I'm sorry that you didn't think more of us in the profession. We should have been allowed that opportunity to assist you. This is what we do every day, and we would have been glad to give you our help. Special education, you just spent some money hiring the Kelly firm to supply us with substitutes. The substitute teacher crisis in this district hasn't been alleviated by that decision. I'm sorry to tell you that. I was hopeful. The Kelly people are sending in substitutes when we get them, and my understanding is the requirement is a bachelor's degree, not anything to do with teaching, just a bachelor's degree. And so, like has happened in the past, when you're not a trained person and you send in a non-trained teacher into a classroom and they have a bachelor's degree, what do you think they know how to do exactly? I don't know what Kelly thinks they know how to do. A bachelor's degree doesn't make you a teacher. Not now, not in the past, not ever. A teacher is a teacher with certain qualifications, certain abilities. You go into a classroom with a bachelor's degree, and somebody hands you a lesson plan, and somebody hands you a textbook, believe me, you're not going to know what to do with that class. And so the people in the buildings are trying to help out. And they're having one heck of a time doing it. And let me say this, for those of you who remember, and I know you do, when you were a student in school and a substitute came in, you know what that meant. And so do our students know. And then you send somebody green into that classroom, really green, never, ever, ever having student taught, having no training whatsoever in how to conduct a class. This is just not good. And I don't know what the expenditure is going to work out to be, but I'm just wondering, is the expenditure more than what would have happened if you just raised the per diem rate for substitutes to come into the Scranton School District? If that might have helped with the solution. There are many unemployed teachers. They know what to do in a classroom. We have substitutes coming in now. They're being told that start time is 8:10. That's true, it is. But a substitute teacher arriving at 8:10 is going to have a problem, a big one. And then a substitute teacher who comes in to work and isn't familiar with the English language and how this operates in our district is also going to have a double problem. You can understand that. So these are some of the issues that are confronting all of us, to say nothing of paper and pencil issues that we need this board to pay attention to and address and help us with. But we have employees going into this district every day to work, and they're getting hurt. And you've got to know that. Every single day, somebody calls and somebody is getting hurt. I don't think anybody expects to go to work and be injured on the job. I think we need to sit down and get this remedied quickly before it's becoming life-threatening. Thank you so much for your kind attention.
Thank you, Ms. Gordon.
Why was there no collaboration with the union on this? I know it has to do with teaching, so I would assume that they would have been collaborated with. Plus, I really didn't understand why we took three teachers' names off that if they were to be, why were they on there in the first place? That didn't sit comfortably with me, but I knew we were up against a May 1st timeline, so if that could just be explained.
Sure. Is Ms. Cortez?
Yes.
Ms. Cartagna, if you would please come forward.
Sure, I would be happy to answer any questions on the special ed plan. The special ed plan is part of the school district's comprehensive plan that was in the works for probably a year, year and a half or so. There were names that were board approved probably that long ago. And then there's committees on the special ed plan, or the comprehensive plan. Some of the committees were regular ed, and some of the committees were special ed. And those appointments probably happened a good year, year and a half ago. The special ed plan was up for review, had to be put on public website for review 30 days before a board vote. We reviewed it, we put it up for public vote or for public access, and we corrected the issues that were talked about earlier in that plan, and that's the reason why it was on display for 30 days, so we could review it and correct any mistakes. The names that were on the front of the special ed plan were part of the comprehensive plan. I removed those long before we sent it in for submission, And it really doesn't need, in the past, it needed a planning committee of various people from the community. And I believe this is the comprehensive plan still made, but the special ed plan doesn't. And what it is a snapshot of what is happening in the district as of the day, as of the time we were working on it. So we went through it, and it really is a work in progress. So we're looking at a plan for the district over the next 3 years of things we're going to bring in, things we're going to fix, issues that need to be addressed over the next 3 years. So because it's in there doesn't mean it's accomplished. It means that there are things we're going to work on. We know there are some issues that really need to be addressed over the next couple of years, and we really looked at the things that we hear from our teachers. I've spoken with the union a number of times already, and we really are taking to heart the issues that need to be addressed in this district. And I think we have a really good head start. We really are understaffed in some areas, and we're looking at fixing those. We have a special ed task force right now that will be coming to the board with some suggestions for how we can staff our district a little bit better, special ed-wise, and hopefully correct some of the issues that are happening on a daily basis.
Ms. Cartagena?
Yes.
I did receive information from the PDE that they have received the submission of the report, that they will review it and come back to us with questions that they might have.
Correct.
And I don't know if you saw that I had forwarded that.
Yes, and that's pretty much typically the process. There are some things in there that have to be in there according to PDE standards. So they'll review the plan, they'll make sure it's correct according to PDE standards. And if there's anything that's not up to par, we'll get a chance to fix those things. They'll counsel us on what needs to be addressed, and then it'll be approved. And the reason we send it in so far in advance, because it's a July 1, I believe, date, is so there's time to go back and forth with PDE about any corrections that need to happen. And then we'll get something from PDE saying it's accepted.
I have one thing, Mrs. Kirsten.
Sure.
There's been a lot of talk, and I think a lot of upsetment, thinking that with new kids coming in back into our district, or coming into our district, our classrooms are going to get overcrowded, and we won't have enough staffing for that. Could you? That's
not
the
idea
looking into. Go ahead, you can talk about
it. I'm looking at enhancing a lot of the programs that we're delivering in special ed. We're really understaffed at the programming level, at the district classroom level is where we're really understaffed. For instance, if a child is having a behavior problem, I have nobody to send in there that could work with the teacher and with the child to help program. So we really don't have any program people. Something like an educational consultant would be, or coach would be, to go into the classrooms to help train, because when you graduate from school, you graduate as a special ed teacher. But then there's areas of expertise. If you're working with students with autism or students with emotional support, there are strategies to use with these children, and we really are very much in need of professional development in those areas. And one of the areas that the task force came up with was professional development at that classroom level, where we could help teachers and students be successful. And if we do bring students back into the district, because that's what we're looking at offering a placement to our students in this district, because this is their home, and this is where they belong, and that's not going to, by any means, overcrowd the classes, because we want to program correctly for the students. So if the caseload is 8, I don't want it to have 12 on it. I mean, I don't want it to have 4 either, but I want it to be manageable so people can work successfully with the students in their classroom. So we're looking at a more equitable way of staffing our classrooms and getting the support into the classrooms that, that the students and the teachers talk to me about on a daily basis.
Thank you.
Okay?
Mrs. Cardenagan?
Sure.
Can you make yourself available later this week? I know we have a busy agenda with the things that's going on in schools, but later this week, and Mrs. Bolin, can you make yourself available this week to have a meeting with myself, Dr. Kerrion, and three of the four of us this week later? We'll get together. I'll get together. I'll give you a call.
I would like to add, Mrs. Bolin and I have established a line of communication, and when things like this are on her mind, she knows all she needs to do is to pick up the phone, and we can discuss these things openly and with the proper staff available. And Rosemary, you know that I'm available for that.
You will be there.
Ms. Ball, we'll look at the schedule tomorrow. Sometime this week, before the end of the week, I would like to meet Dr.
Everybody,
make yourself available. Okay, Ms. Bowen?
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mrs. Carpenter.
Ryan Martin and Cassie Morrell. Casey Morrell?
Casey.
Good evening, board members, Dr. Kerrion, and all other district administrative staff members, and welcome to West Grand High School. My name is Cassie Merrill, and I am president of the senior class. With me tonight is Student Council President Brian Martin. Tonight, we would like to share with you some of the great things happening here at the home of the Invaders.
We wish to start by saying that as of this morning, students from West Grand have been accepted to 65 institutions of higher education across the nation. As a whole, the senior class has had over 204 individual college acceptances to universities next year.
We are proud to announce that three senior students at West, Jake McDonald, Brian Martin, and Danny Saladin, were named 2016 Scholastic Superstars by the Times Tribune. Three juniors also participated in the Leadership Lackawanna's Tomorrow's Leaders Today program throughout this year, and they will graduate this outstanding program on Thursday, May 19th.
Advanced placement testing began this morning with the AP Chemistry exam. Students from all nine advanced placement courses offered here at West are signed up to take these exams, which will be administered from today until Friday, May 13th. AP courses are designed to simulate a freshman level course in college, and students who pass their AP exams will be awarded college credit in that course. In addition to preparing for the AP exams, West Grant students are also preparing for the rapidly approaching Keystone exams, which will be administered from Monday, May 16th to Monday, May 23rd.
On Wednesday, May 4th at 6 p.m., West will hold our National Honor Society induction ceremony in our beautiful auditorium. On May 11th at 7 p.m., we will host our annual spring choral concert in the auditorium. And on May 15th, our strings, band, and choral concert will be held at 2 p.m. in the auditorium. On May 25th at 6, we will have our Invader Award ceremony, also here in the auditorium. We hope to see all of you at these great programs.
Our spring sports programs are in full swing, and each sport is enjoying a good, productive season. Tennis and track and field district meets are rapidly approaching, and we wish our participating athletes the best of luck as they compete in districts. Our senior baseball and softball team members will be honored on Monday, May 16th for senior night. Baseball will hold at senior night at Battaglia Cauley Field, and softball at our home field right behind us. Both ceremonies will begin at 4:30 p.m., and we wish to see all of you there.
Many West students have signed up to take the SAT being administered at Scranton High School on Saturday, May 7th. In order to help our students perform at the utmost of their abilities, we are offering both the reading and math workshop on May 5th and 6th in order to teach valuable testing strategies to our students. There is also a PTA meeting being held on May 12th at 6 p.m. in our alumni room.
On Monday, May 9th, our physics department and outdoor club will be sponsoring a viewing of the transit of Mercury. This phenomena occurs approximately once every 8 years, and we are extremely fortunate to possess right here at West technology that allows us to witness this event. On May 11th, our AP United States History and European History students will travel to the Holocaust Memorial exhibit being placed at Marywood University. Also on May 11th, the Special Olympics will be hosted at Memorial Stadium. Many students from West have agreed to volunteer their time for this worthy cause.
On Monday, May 16th, our Building Middle States Committee will meet at the end of the school day. Last year, West was recredited by the Middle States Association, and we are already in the process of approving our school for reaccreditation in a few short years. The Armed Forces Parade will take place on Saturday, May 21st, and our school will have several groups participating in this parade.
On Friday, May 20th, our chorus club will travel to Ohio to compete in the Music in the Parks choral competition. The chorus club has a very strong history and reputation in this competition, and we wish them the best of luck as they compete this year. May 3rd is National Teacher Appreciation Day, and May 22nd is National Nurse Appreciation Day. We want to take this opportunity, as representatives are of our entire student body, to thank our teachers and nurses for all that they do for us on a daily basis.
Our school is also running a trip to Boston this year. Students and chaperones attending the trip will depart West on Thursday, May 12th, and return Sunday, May 15th. We will hold a Prom Promise Assembly for seniors on May 26th. This program showcases the dangers of drunk driving. On Friday, May 27th, our senior prom will be held at the Radisson, and the senior class trip to Hershey Park will take place on May 31st.
And this brings us to the ends of our announcements this evening. On behalf of Cassie, myself, and the rest of the Senior Student Council and class officers, we want to thank you very much for the opportunity to work with you throughout the school year. I now want to introduce the class president and student council president for the 2016-2017 school year, Kaylee Martinelli and Jasmine Bailey.
Martinelli, and I'm honored to stand here before you. I am the class president of the 2016-2017 senior class, and I'm looking forward to talking to all of you.
Good evening and welcome. My name is Jasmine Mailer. I'm the 2016-2017 student council president. It's an honor to meet all of you, and I look forward to working with you next year.
Thank you. Larry Gallagher.
Session. We read into contents of that resolution, and then the board members read through it fully, and then we make a decision as a whole. That was brought up the last second, and that's why we didn't mean when we were confused over it. We were just, it was just put in front of us the last minute, and we made exceptions for that thing. From that point on, we don't do that. We read a resolution and we read into it and we talk about it in a work session. Then we bring it forward for passage.
And if something's brought up at the last minute, if something's brought up at the last minute, can it just be tabled to your next meeting?
Well, it can be,
Mr. Gallagher. It doesn't have to be voted on at that point.
Exactly. And we.
And all I'm saying is, as a taxpayer, I'm like, I would appreciate you making sure of what you're voting on you understand.
We fully understand what you're saying.
Along those same lines.
Mr. Gallagher, can I make a comment on that?
Sure.
You're absolutely right. I for one knew exactly what I was voting on. I didn't like the format. I didn't like the presentation, as Mr. Sheridan just enumerated, the fact that it wasn't presented to us in written form for adequate and proper discussion and consideration. It wasn't. At the same time, we passed that resolution. I believe it was 6-3. So, I mean, we passed that resolution. I thought it was unanimous. I thought it was unanimous. Yes, I did. I thought it was unanimous. I didn't remember a dissenting vote. But then, I knew what it was.
But then,
I knew what it was.
You got a new contract without putting it out to bid.
Well, I for one voted against it. So you understand, I'm in complete agreement with you. I'm not arguing with you.
That's my point. As a taxpayer, I'm like, it was never put out to bid. The transparency issue was not there. I'm like, anything over $10,000, I mean, the bus contract is well over $10,000, then it should be put out to bid. Whether the bus company that actually gets it now may still have got it if it put out to bid. But it's not fair to the taxpayers not to put it out to bid. Along those same lines, the board was presented with the fact that there was 27 pay periods this year instead of the usual 26. And the board, I'm only saying what I see in the paper, the board's approved to pay the 27 periods. And then we didn't realize that it was going to be over $400,000. Again, it's a pattern that things are done without looking at all the facts, without looking at what the whole costs are. We are saddled with the extra pay period, payment of it, the taxpayers. I'm like, I believe the board should have taken the time to actually look at it and say, well, what is it going to cost? I'm like, if you run a business and you're paying somebody $10,000 and they're being paid in 26 periods, it's divided up over 26. If there happens to be 27 that year, divided up over 27. You wouldn't just give them an extra pay period. That was basically giving everyone who would receive that an extra 126th of their pay, which actually came out to over $400,000.
Give that a little explanation to that, what happened by law?
I can answer. There was a determination made that those workers were hourly workers, so they were actually paid for the period of time or the period of hours that they would have worked, as opposed to salaried workers, which is an annual salary versus an hourly wage. There's a distinction, and it's a distinction with a difference. If there's a determination that they're an hourly worker, then they're entitled to those 27 pays because they actually earn those 27 pays, some of the hours being from the previous year when the pay period hits in the beginning of the new year. And then that particular year, which happens once every 11 years, has 27 pays in it. So they're paid for the actual hours that they're worked, as opposed to a lump sum salary in a category.
Then basically, how would it cost us more money?
Well, it may cost you more money, but the determination, and the court cases are pretty clear on it, if they're determined to be an hourly worker, they've got to be paid for the hours that they work. They didn't get extra money, they got money for the hours that they worked. If they're salaried workers, they'd only get an annual.
Okay, I understand that you're only paid for the hours that you're working, and someone's only going to be paid for what they work. I'm like, then it was someone presented it wrong in the paper when they said that it would actually cost them.
District.
It was presented in the paper that because of agreeing that it would pay for 27 pay periods, that it was going to cost the district over $400,000 extra. Well, my question is, how would it cost us more money if all we're paying them is their hourly wages anyhow? It shouldn't make any difference at all.
Well, quite frankly. just so happens that in this given year, there were 27 pays. Is that correct, Mr. Sunday? On an hourly basis? It's not an hourly basis.
That would be determined at the end of the year. Based upon what we did, we've always paid the normal 27 versus 26.
No, you were always paying 26, but in this year, you waited actually 27.
We actually have on the 11th, in my tenure here, in the 11th year, when it was a 27 pay, they were paid by divided by 27, not by 26.
Wait, repeat that back. You said they were paid by divided by 27.
The annual salary at the time was divided by 27 as opposed to 26.
And what is it this year?
It was changed to hourly. That was a decision. That was a grievance procedure that was brought before the board.
And the determination was that they were hourly and not salary. That's the distinction. So they were paid for the number of hours they worked, as opposed to a lump sum salary.
So, I'm like, they didn't, their salary for the year is the same as what it would normally be.
That's correct, because they were paid for the number of hours they worked based on their hourly wage as opposed to their salary.
Okay. But then how does someone explain why they said in the paper that it would cost an extra $400,000 by doing it the way that you did it?
Because it was determined that they were hourly workers, they were paid for the number of hours they worked as opposed to their salary.
So, next year they will actually get less money?
Correct.
But they will work the same number, they're still going to work a whole year?
They're actually going to work less hours next year. Because some of those hours within that pay were actually carried over into the 2016 year from 2015.
So basically they're getting their same salary, but part of what they received in 2016 were hours that they worked in 2015.
That's correct.
So in 2015, the budget should have been less money for those workers because they weren't paid for that period of time in 2015.
I can't answer that question for you.
I'm just trying to figure this out.
Yeah, that's not something I looked at.
I feel that it's like...
Can I ask you a question? The anomaly is the calendar, obviously.
Sure.
All right. And our salaried employees, our teachers, our administrators, they actually have a reduction of their 26, their normal 26 amount, because they have a 27 amount to pick up. I think it's like 3.8% lower to add up to that 27th check. I believe, again, Mr. Gallagher, you're making an accurate appraisal here. You are. The issue that was presented to us was that having been arbitrated with the city of Scranton twice, fire and police, both times the city lost on the position that we were taking, that we were not going to add a paycheck. So we were faced with pay them or be facing an arbitration that is a certain loser, and there will then be the amount of money that we have to pay them plus interest once that gets disposed. That was what was presented to me in our executive session. I, for one, having taught in the district for 35 years, went through that three different times where we had reduced paychecks that year because we had an extra paycheck. But the clerical and custodial workers union are hourly workers. That's their declaration. That's how we paid them. That's our new contract. Correct? Isn't that our most recent contract? We gave them hourly raises?
Yes.
So that's where that came from. I mean, we were between a rock and a hard place.
I'm like, I don't understand how it would be a problem if they're hourly employees, if they're paid by their hours. I'm like, I don't understand where that would become a problem of paying them an extra pay period. Because they're only being paid for what they work
Right.
So they all have to punch a time clock.
Exactly.
So they only get paid for what it was. So I don't understand how all of a sudden that becomes a problem and it comes out that it's good, it says it's going to cost the district over $400,000 more.
I had the same problem with the math as you do, but I was being, we were being shown the history of the arbitration awards given in the city to the fire and the police over the same issue, and we were being presented for the first time that this was going to be, a grievance was going to lead to an arbitration filing if we were to follow that same, not follow that same policy. So as the city does it, and they do, we did it this year. But we were in a no-win situation as far as what our legal counsel was telling us. And I believe they're right, because the city did lose two arbitrations.
The city loses every arbitration.
Mr. Gallagher,
like, I believe you, like, if the city was running, if it was the unions against the city with the busing contract, that would not hold up. It would go out to bid.
Mr. Gallagher, if you have any further questions, we could arrange a meeting with Mr. Minor or Mr. Sunday to collaborate any more of your questions that you may have, or you may have need some more time to sit down and understand it.
That's okay. I think it would behoove the board to put out that it didn't cost the city more money. You were only paying everyone by their hours that they worked. So no one was getting more money. They weren't getting an extra paycheck. Let people know that that's actually what happened. It would actually help. It would improve the board. In closing, all I would like to say is, between that and with the resolution, I really feel that each and every one of you, every time you're voting on something, if you don't understand it, ask a question. And don't vote for something that you don't understand. Because it's people's tax dollars.
Well, like I said,
you honored all those students tonight. If they didn't understand something, they asked their teachers for a clarification so that they would understand.
Well,
otherwise, they wouldn't have done as well as they did.
I agree with you, but like I said, that under that resolution that night, the contents of that, it wasn't that we didn't understand anything.
Well,
let
me finish one thought of that. That was in the fall. When you were asked about the bus contract last month, you said, well, we didn't understand that.
No.
If you didn't, that's what the paper said.
Well,
if you have a problem, like you were saying, we didn't understand what that resolution was
about.
That was months later. At that point in time, that should have been resolved. You should have understood.
A lot of
and been able to give an answer that why we weren't doing it.
A lot of things that are read not comprehended
Excuse
by the papers.
We voted on to extend the contract, the same contract. Okay?
It's not the same contract because there are changes.
It's an extension of the contract.
But there are changes to the contract.
Yeah, additional money for the district. $300,000 a year.
Yeah. And
okay.
And how much is diesel fuel now as opposed to 2012?
Excuse me?
How much is diesel fuel cost now as opposed to
2012? I haven't a clue. All I know was $300,000 additional a year, okay? That equaled out probably about $1 million.
$1.3 million.
$1.3 million.
And how much the diesel costs have gone down in that period of time?
I don't know. I'm not checking.
How much would we have saved if we had put it out to bid? That's all I'm saying. Is some transparency.
Solicitor Minora, did our busing contract have anything to do with diesel fuel or any fuel whatsoever?
No. We saved a significant amount of money last year, and I can tell you that there are some fuel clauses in our contract and in previous years. He's never enforced them when prices have gone up or down, so it's actually worked out to our benefit in that regard. But the changes that we made last year to the busing contract in terms of runs saved us almost $750,000.
Could have also not saved as much money.
In a district that desperately needed the money at this time without a budget from the state. $1.3 million is a lot of money.
When I requested that Solicitor Minora approached our busing provider, it was in a time where we didn't have a light at the end of the tunnel with the state budget. We still don't. And requesting we could save money. In a district when we need every penny that we can get, which I'm going to bring up later under new business as well with our county. I made the suggestion that if we could save $1.3 million, that's a home run for us. No matter what upside factors are there. I'll vote yes. I voted yes on it once. I'll vote yes on it again. He saved $1.3 million.
And I voted no because we'll never know what we could have saved had we bid it. And I will vote no again.
Programs that we have here for not only regular ed students, but special education students. They are insufficient and inadequate. Because of these lack of programs, supports, and resources that are not being provided to the special education students, my daughter's regular education is being affected. And I am here on behalf of regular education students, because they too matter and they need to be heard. And if I need to start a grassroots movement, I will. I am appalled at driving and seeing a billboard asking for parents to call them if their child has an IEP, frequent suspensions, failing grades. What about everybody else? One thing I would like to point out that was taken away and was not told to me as a parent from my daughter, who, by the way, in fourth grade read and got a 100% on the AR test To Kill a Mockingbird. Fourth grade. And read Da Vinci Code. No one knows about that. We don't have time. And I'm sick of it. They matter too. And another thing that was taken away from her, and it has been around in this district since I was in it, was the oral reading contest. My daughter, for 3 years in a row, won the entire shebang. The 700 plus students that our district has, gone, taken away from her. Was I told? No. Found out at work. She found out from her teacher. Came home, wanted to know why. Mom, why'd they do that? That's not fair. I said, Lainey, you know, you're right. And I'm done. I'm done sitting back and knowing that all of this is happening in education, and I know it's not even something like that could be resolved here at the local level. It's education in general right now. It's disheartening. I'm upset as a parent. I want regular education to matter as much as special education. She matters. And all students matter. And special education students, I was a special ed teacher, so I don't want this to be taken wrong, but I'm an advocate for regular ed, because they matter too. And if we don't give the support, the resources, that teachers need in the classroom, and that paraprofessionals need in the classroom, that my daughter's regular education is going to be affected, and that is not fair. So do I get to sue? Do I get to go to due process? Because she is not being challenged because the teachers don't have time? It's not fair. I want it to be better for her and for all students. And again, I don't, because I was a special ed teacher, and I don't want anybody to think I'm coming from, I'm just trying to speak for them, because I don't think anybody does. So I hope I did not sound rude or, and another thing I want to point out, sorry, because I'm nervous. When AR was stripped away, it was very interesting. My daughter came home and said, you know what, Mom? My friends aren't reading. I'm really bothered by that. I said, Lainey, I'm bothered by it too because my students really aren't reading as much as they did. I said, but what matters is that you're reading. She has over 200 AR points and is still pushing ahead. But to attain what? There is no special prize for her. What about them? They need to be recognized too. In the classroom and outside of the classroom, just as much as any other student. So I thank you for listening to me. I hope I did not sound rude or come across mean. I'm here because I care, and I have heart in everything that I do. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Ms. Wilson. The assignment has been exhausted. Is there anybody else that would like to address the board? Say your name, sir.
Yes, Jerry Baldoff, Scranton Federation of Teachers. To Mr. Gallagher's point, the busing contract does mention diesel fuel. There's a maximum amount and a minimum amount. By contract, if the price of diesel goes above a certain number, the district is on the hook. If it drops below a certain price, then you're to get a refund. But that is in the contract.
Thank you. I'll entertain a motion to put the consent agenda, items 10 through 16.
I'd like to make a motion to accept the consent agenda.
Second.
Hearing a second on the question. Hearing no question, roll call.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Abstain.
Mr. Dwight?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Oleski?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
7 affirmative, 1 abstention. Motion passes.
Okay. 17. Accept the motion from 9 consent agenda. Let's start with D15.
To the members of the Board of Directors of the Scranton School District, the following resolution is presented for your consideration. Whereas the Scranton School District receives federal funding through Title I, Part A, Title I of the Elementary and Secondary Education Act, as amended ESEA, to provide financial assistance to schools with high numbers or high percentages of children from low-income families to help ensure that all children meet challenging state academic standards. And whereas for compliance with Title I, the district must approve an annual equity plan highlighting the number of teachers by building that are highly qualified in their subject area and the number of novice teachers in each building. And whereas the equity plan also addresses corrective actions and steps the district will take to ensure that all teachers are highly qualified and no building has an unfair percentage of new teachers or non-highly qualified teachers. And now, therefore, be it resolved the Scranton School Board of Directors approves the equity plan for 2016-2017 per the attached, respectively submitted.
Second. Hearing a second on the question. Hearing no question, roll call.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwight?
Yes.
Mr. Lesh?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Oleski?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes. Policy Director Timlin.
It's the recommendation of the Superintendent and the Policy Committee to adopt the Standards of Conduct Policy as per the attached, respectfully submitted.
Second. Hearing a second, another question? Hearing no question, roll call.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olefsky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
It's the recommendation of the superintendent and the policy committee to adopt the travel reimbursement policy as per the attached, respectfully submitted.
Second. Hearing a second, another question? Hearing no question, roll call.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olefsky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
It is the recommendation of the superintendent and the policy committee to adopt the cash management policy as per the attached, respectfully submitted.
Second. Hearing a second, another question? Hearing no question, roll call.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olefsky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
The recommendation of the superintendent and the policy committee to adopt the principles for governance and leadership as established by the Pennsylvania School Boards Association, respectfully submitted.
Second. Hearing a second, another question? Hearing no question, roll call.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olefsky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Lush? Mr. Sheridan?
Yes. Thank you, Mr. Timlin. Personnel, Director Olefsky.
To the members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, is a recommendation of the Personnel Committee that the attached list of appointments, assignments, resignations, leaves, and absences be approved. Respectfully submitted.
Second. Hearing a second. Another question? Under no question, roll call.
Mrs. Olefsky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Eight affirmative.
Members of the Board of School Directors of the City of Scranton, the employee has completed at least 3 years of professional services with satisfactory rating for achieving the status of professional employee under the school code. It is the recommendation of the Superintendent of Schools that the professional contract be issued to the following individuals. Barney Wilkins, date of appointment, December 7th, 2009. And Mary Kate Finn Ryder, date of appointment, August 30th, 2012. Respectfully submitted.
Second. I'm hearing another question. Second. Another question?
On the question, Mr. Chairman, I'd like to congratulate Barney Wilkins and Mary Kate Finn Ryder for achieving tenured status. Congratulations.
Who else has any questions?
For the record, Mr. Green, these were just omissions from the last list.
Yes, these two individuals had extenuating circumstances that weren't caught until after the list was passed.
Thank you.
Roll call.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Timlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Dwyer?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olefsky?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes.
Affirmative.
Special Education, Director Olefsky.
To the members of Board of Directors, the Special Education Committee hereby recommends the following resolution for your consideration. Whereas the School District of the City of Scranton, and subject of administration procedures and civil suits within the appropriateness of a student's special education program, has been challenged, where suits have been filed on the matters of SDSS ODR 1767-1516-AE and ODR 1719-3-1516-KE, and whereas the parties have reached a settlement agreement in the matter upon the terms and conditions previously provided for your consideration. Therefore, be it resolved that the settlements, as indicated above, be approved upon the terms and condition as described, and the superintendent and directors of special education are hereby authorized to execute any or all documents necessary to consummate the matters. Respectfully submitted.
Second. Hearing a second, another question? Hearing no question, roll call.
Mr. Tinlin?
Yes.
Mr. Casey?
Yes.
Mr. Devine?
Yes.
Mr. Lush?
Yes.
Mr. McAndrew?
Yes.
Mrs. Olefsky?
Yes.
Mr. Schuster?
Yes.
Mr. Sheridan?
Yes. New business?
Yes, sir. Something under new business, Mr. President.
Good.
I have an issue with where the superintendent has created her own policy without board knowledge or approval in the form of a confidentiality agreement that she had her executive staff sign. I don't believe that this fosters the climate of communication, collaboration, and transparency, which I thought was the vision for the district. I believe that this creates a barrier when board members reach out to the expertise in the district to develop agendas for committee meetings. I would like with the support of the board that we have these agreements removed from the employee files and destroyed. I mean, we set policy and we did not vote on this.
Mr. McAndrew, if I can answer that. The last meeting you weren't there, we did discuss it with the board, and we came to an agreement with Dr. Kurian that if we were going to contact one of the administrators for any information, we'll give her the benefit to call the doctor and let her know, because I think she should be informed of what we're doing, and so she can help us. That helps her job a little bit more. But at the same time, that it does not stop us as board of directors to contact any of the administrators and get the information that we do need. And I think we came to a happy agreement with that. So I don't know if I had a chance to talk it over there with you since you weren't at the meeting last month, but that's an agreement. So I don't know if you want to still ask for what you're asking.
Well, I am. Where was that discussed? I'm not sure.
That was discussed in the work session. Last Monday at the work session.
As of this point, you're still in files, correct?
Pardon?
As of this point, these confidentiality agreements are still in files, though?
Well, I think we gave the candidate a meeting that they would be... what was the agreement, Dr.?
The confidentiality agreements protect the district, the employee, other employees, and our students. They are relevant to anyone in the district who has confidential information running through their hands. And according to FERPA and HIPAA, this is a way to protect the district. There's nothing unusual or different about this type of management. It is not a policy. Everyone is asked if they will sign. No one is forced to sign, and there has not been any objection, and these have been in existence for just about a year now. So why this is coming up at this point makes me very curious. Mr. Minora, would you like to comment?
I reviewed the confidentiality agreements a week or so ago. I think Mark and I provided them to you. They seem to cover the FERPA, HIPAA, and personnel. FERPA, HIPAA, I mean, that is the law. Beyond that, I think you covered it, Doctor.
You also have 18 policies in your policy manual that request confidentiality in a number of different areas. I have put that into one document for the protection of the district. Your job is to make policy. Mine is to carry out that policy, and this is how I chose to do it.
Okay, Doctor, I'd like to just discuss, I think where our agreement was that we all agreed upon at the work session. Tell me if I'm wrong, that if a board of director has a right, except for children's personal information, but anything else to do administrative-wise has a right to contact any administrator that we need to, but we did agree that we would give benefit of doubt to call you and let you know, you know, where we're going with this. Like, if we wanted to call Greg Sunday, Department of Finance, and we want to talk about the budget, we would let you know and say, listen, we're going to be, Bobby, Director Lesh is going to be calling Sunday,
yeah.
Mr. Sunday, for certain information. You would be notified, so you're...
That is all I ask for, is notification from the board members prior to going to the staff. I report to the board, the staff reports to me, so I have no objection with you reaching out, but in order to manage effectively and to ensure that you get the correct information, my preference is that I be notified of the request.
Is there any reason why we would be turned down?
Well,
because I'm still wondering why I wasn't allowed to hear from someone who I needed to speak to in a committee meeting.
Senior staff is here at your disposal at all of the board meetings. They are prepared to answer your questions. Again, you go from these people report to me. The people you want to reach out to in the audience report to them. It's up to them to call on that person. That is the formality that I would prefer as the superintendent.
So,
well, I think what he's trying to say, Doctor, is that when we reach out to one of the administrators, that they're not going to be able to say to us, well, we can't give you that information because the superintendent asked us not to. I give you the opportunity. We're going to call you, and then we're going to reach out to Mr. Sunday or Mr. Gaynard or anybody. They're to know that if a board of directors reaches out for information, we're going to call you and let you know what we're doing. And
my request is just going forward, if I need to speak to someone at a committee meeting, that it be honored. That's it. I'm not going to ask, to unveil anything that I shouldn't know.
If that'll make you happy, Mr. Casey, I'm just trying to establish some order and some way that we can manage this district together without either party going above and beyond their authority.
Okay. Anything on there else on the new business?
Yes, Mr. Sheridan, I'd like to ask permission of the board to have Solicitor Minora draft up a letter and we send to the county commissioners asking for, in lieu of taxes, the $130,000 from the Globe sale purchase.
I'm going to invoke Rule 9 of the board. Put that in writing for board consideration, and then we can bring it to the board as a resolution. And I don't need a second. It's a reasonable request, but I think it should be put in writing. We can then consider it in executive session, and then we can vote on it in a resolution if we feel it's appropriate.
It's Rule 8.
It's Rule 8. Thank you, Mr. McCann. Rule number 8.
Thank you.
Anything else on the business?
Just trying to save money.
Okay, under the President's report, I'd like to again congratulate all the students, their parents, and the teachers. I'm proud for one. I think this whole board and the superintendent and everybody in this district is very proud of our students for what they've achieved in these goals. It's a fabulous job. I also like to congratulate Mr. Robert Genoleza and Mrs. Timlin, Mrs. Missy McTiernan for their new promotions. You have done a great job, Mr. Genoleza. Because of your knowledge, your experience, and your skills, and I applaud you for that. And I think you're going to do a great job in your new endeavor. Missy McTiernan, the same way. Scranton, South Scranton Junior High School runs accurate, and it runs on the ball. It's a great school. With her leadership, did she do great, and I'm sure she's going to do great in her new job. Congratulations to both of you. Thank you. With that, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
Meeting adjourned.